So Windows 11 is finally out and we can all download and install the full version and take advantage of it, which is great. So in this video, I'm going to show you from start to finish how to create the install media and then how to install Windows 11 on your PC, new or old. So let's get started. So first off, we'll click on the start button and just type TPM.msc and press enter. Now this will tell us if your computer supports TPM. Okay, so we can see right over here, TPM is ready for use. So TPM, or Trusted Platform Module, is a security, a device placed on your motherboard. It would have already come with your motherboard or can be enabled through BIOS updates that puts a form of encryption on your storage, your M.2 SSD, your mechanical hard drive, your regular SSD, so that if your drive and your motherboard become separated, that information on the drive is essentially worthless. I'm sure somehow it can be decrypted, but for the most part, that drive is worthless, that information is worthless, and a hacker or whatever can't get to it, supposedly. Anyway, let's check that. That was on an AMD platform. Let's check on an Intel platform real quick. So that was on the EVGA X570 dartboard. This is on the EVGA Z390 dartboard. This is an Intel platform. The last one was an AMD platform. Thankfully, both are ready for TPM use. Let me show you what it looks like on Intel in the BIOS. So come over here under Advanced Configuration, and then we'll go over here into Advanced, Trusted Computing, and then we'll see Security Device Support Enabled, TPM 2.0 UEFI Spec Version, TGC_2. And then of course, to show you that it shows up here, TPM 20 Device Found, to let you know that TPM is enabled on this board. So as I mentioned before, the first one was an AMD platform, the second one being an Intel platform. So it'll work both ways. Now, it just has to be if your board is supported. Some boards are supported, some boards aren't. You can find out for sure on your motherboard support site. So Asus, EVGA, Gigabyte, ASRock, whoever it may be, check on their websites for your board and check on the support site for your motherboard manual. Your motherboard manual will tell you for certain if your motherboard supports TPM. Now, let me know down in the comments below if no matter what, your board still doesn't have TPM. I'll see if I can put together a guide on how to make Windows 11 work even on boards that don't support TPM. So now with that out of the way, let's go ahead and create the media to install Windows 11. I'll have a link to this website down in the description below, but first check out the video and then of course you can follow along afterwards. So we'll come to this website and then we'll click Create Windows Installation Media and Download Now. Then we'll just go ahead and open that up. Make sure to read through all of this and accept. If English is not your native language, uncheck this and create whichever version you'd like. But I'll leave this unchecked regardless of that. Then I'll click Next. Okay, USB flash drive. It is an 8 gig drive, so I'll go ahead and click Next here. I already have one inserted, by the way. And so it picks it up here. It's already a Windows 10 drive. I'm just going to go ahead and reuse it for Windows 11 and click Next. So creating the media is going to take a few seconds depending on your bandwidth and of course your PC speed. Now, the Windows 10, of course, when I bought it, it has a key. I have the legal key right over here. Like Windows 10, you don't have to put in a key to install it and it will let you use it for whatever period of time. And then of course, you're going to get that watermark on the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. Regardless, it will still work. All right, now my flash drive is now ready. So click finish, make sure, because if not, it won't be complete. It does its little thing towards the end. Now we'll go ahead and just close it out of here. We'll come here, File Explorer, and you can see this is the Windows 11 installer. So we'll go ahead and restart the PC and go into the BIOS. Now, mind you, every single motherboard is going to have a different sort of BIOS, but the method is going to be relatively the same. We'll go into Advanced Configurations, enter Setup, and we go into Advanced. Now you're going to want to make sure to come into Trusted Computing. Make sure your Security Device Support is set to Enable. And below that, your TPM 2.0 UEFI Spec Version to TCG-2. then coming out of here. On AMD boards, you're given the, on some AMD boards, you're given AMD FTPM configuration. That's more for working with BitLocker, a feature of Windows. I don't myself like to use BitLocker, so I'll just leave that disabled. You can go ahead and enable it if you'd like. Now coming out of there, we'll come over to boot. If you have a new motherboard, it's always going to be on UEFI. Older motherboards, you want to make sure that you're not on legacy, you're set to UEFI. UEFI will give you this kind of GUI BIOS, though there are different methods of achieving it that motherboard manufacturers have enabled, but for the most part, it'll give you this GUI. So just make sure it's set to UEFI. You can see right over here, we have boot option number one. That's my USB thumb drive. Boot option two, since my SSD already has Windows on it, the one that you saw me already downloaded from, you're going to see Windows Boot Manager, and that will be there when you do Windows 11, but you'll see that during the install. And then you want to make sure that UEFI generic flash is the first boot option. And then in case you have multiple, just select it here under boot option number one. So now we'll go ahead, save and exit. Under boot override, we're going to go ahead, select UEFI generic flash. Select your language, time and currency, and keyboard input method, and we'll go next. Install now. If you have a key, you can enter it here now. For me, since I do so many of these install videos, I generally don't use my install key. I use the free version they let you use for a while. The key I use more for my workstation. And select, I don't have a product key. Select your version of Windows 11 or the version that you're going to buy a key for if you do end up buying a key. Mine is Pro. Make sure to read through all this incredibly important information. Click I accept. Next. If you already have Windows 10 installed on your SSD or mechanical drive, you can always choose upgrade. I don't like to do that because if you have a tiny issue on your previous install, when you do an upgrade, it becomes a tremendous issue. Or can over time. So I always do custom brand new install. So I select custom. Now all of those drive zeros are part of the same drive. They say drive zero and then all the partitions under it. So I like to delete each and every partition to create one entire drive. Now, if you have other drives in the machine, I recommend you unplug them all just from power or data, whichever of the two you don't need both, probably data if the machine is on. Disconnect all of those and then click refresh. That way that your current drive, the drive that you want to install Windows on, is the only drive, because if not, the Windows boot partition is going to be spread across all the other drives. So if you disconnect one later on, it might create an actual issue when you go to boot from your SSD. Anyway, let's get back to it. Under drive zero, unallocated space, next. Now, if this is like Windows 7, this part, the install will take probably less than 7 minutes. All right, and you can either wait for it or just click restart now. I'll click restart now. All right, so this already looks a little bit different than Windows 10. So we'll select our language or our country of region and yes. Keyboard layout, US. We'll go ahead and skip keyboard layout. All right, let's name your device. And we'll do next. All right, so we'll set it up for personal use and next. Let's add your Microsoft account. So let's see, sign in options, sign in with a security key, offline account, forgot my username. For now, I'm going to do offline account and then one account for everything. Cool. Skip for now. Enter your name, Iggy, and I don't want a password, so I just press enter on that. And make sure to read through all of this, but for now I'm just going to go ahead and click accept. This looks nice. All right, so we're now in Windows 11. A lot of people are kind of weirded out about everything being moved over to the center. I kind of like it. It's different. It's new. It's, you know, you'll get used to it. These are all the pinned apps, which is nice. Used to be over here and you'd have to scroll through it. Now it's in the center. Your settings. Now, one of the first things you're going to want to do, aside from install the drivers and everything, which I have a separate video, I'll go ahead and link that up. But after you install all those drivers, one of the most important things you're going to want to do is a Windows update. And then, you know, download all of the updates. Now, a new update just came out. It was probably this one, just came out. So this is definitely important to do. Now, mind you, the video I linked up above a few seconds ago shows you how to install all of the drivers for your particular motherboard to make sure you get the most performance out of your system. Windows Update is going to have all or most of those drivers, but they're generally not the best for your system. If they do work perfectly, they're going to give you mediocre performance at best. If you use the specific drivers, you're going to get the most performance that you can out of your system. Of course, aside from overclocking and all that other stuff you could potentially do. And as always, please do go ahead and leave a comment below if you have any kind of questions, comments, or concerns. I do reply to every one of them. And as always, please do click like and subscribe. It helps me out a ton. That way I can keep bringing you bigger and better videos just like this. This is Iggy with This Bytes For You, showing you how to install Windows 11 from start to finish. Iggy up. See you guys.